Hi guys, it is Rochelle here. Welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be another shifting video and we are going to talk about reality shifting scripts. You may ask, what is a reality shifting script? Well, scripting for reality shifting is when you write down everything that happens in your desired reality, also known as your DR. You might also ask, is it necessary and why? Well, I'm gonna tell you this. Shifting scripts help you get a good grasp of your DR. I guess you don't have to script if you don't want to, but I'd say most people do, just because I find your script really helpful in helping you to see what your DR looks like. I've been reading your comments in my previous shifting videos, and there were quite a few questions about scripting for reality shifting. So I thought I would film this video in hopes to answer all of your questions. In this video, I will be telling you some of the important elements to include in your shifting script, and I will also be giving you suggestions on what to write in your script. This will also be a script with me because I will be taking you along with me while I create my new and updated shifting script. This is totally random, but I thought I would just put a little disclaimer out there. When I talk about scripts when referring to shifting, it's a little weird for me because I am a film student and I do write film scripts as well. And film scripts are completely different than scripts for shifting. So when I mention scripts for shifting, you might hear me say shifting script a lot because in my mind, I have to add the word shifting before to distinguish the two whenever I think or speak of it. Yeah, so if you're wondering, or maybe not, but if you're wondering why I say shifting script a lot instead of just script, that is why. Anyways, before we get into this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'd really love if you did. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. With that, let's just get into this video. Okay, so one important thing that I want to mention before we get into the script with me is that when you are writing your shifting script, you want to write it as it's happening. You want to write your shifting script in the first person point of view, not the third person point of view. In your shifting script, I think there are three important categories that compose the entire script. The first category is about you, the second is your DR world life, and the third are the rules. I'll be covering what you can include in each of these categories, but I'm going to be starting with about you. So to write out my script, I prefer to type it. I'm just going to pull up a Word document and just start typing away, but you don't have to do it the same way I'm going to do it. You can write out your script in the traditional way with pen and paper, or you can type it out on your phone. That works too. I didn't mention this earlier, but I want to shift to Hogwarts, so this will be a shifting to Hogwarts script with me. Okay, so the first element you want to write in the about you category is your name. Your name in your DR world can be the same as your name in your CR world, or if you want, you could have a completely different name in your DR. For example, if you want to be related to a character in your DR, you can just change your last name so that it is the same as that character. For me, I don't really want to be related to anybody in my DR world. You know, I just kind of want to be myself in my DR world. So all I'm gonna say is my name is Rochelle. The next thing you can include in this category is your age and gender. I am not going to script my DR self to be the same age as my CR self, just because I want to attend Hogwarts as a student. And if my CR age was the same as my DR age, I would have graduated from Hogwarts already. I'm going to say that I am a 16-year-old girl, and I am in my sixth year at Hogwarts. If you are shifting to Hogwarts like me, that is something you want to remember. Your age will determine your year. Another thing you can put in your script is your birthday. I don't know why, but I don't want my DR birthday to be the same as my CR birthday. So I'm just gonna say my birthday is May 1st, 1980. I just picked a random month and date, but I picked the year 1980 because I want to be the same age as Harry Potter. So being born in the same year as him would mean we would be attending Hogwarts together at the same time. Also, because I want to attend Hogwarts, I think this is an important element to include in your shifting script, and that is your accent. As you can tell, I do not have a British or Scottish accent. That means I would probably stand out if I were to attend Hogwarts like this. To fix that, I'm gonna script myself to have a British accent. Another important thing you want to include with the accent is that you will speak like the British, because the way the British speak is a little bit different than how the Americans speak, or Canadians for me. For example, we call pants pants, while the British calls pants trousers. I will have a British accent, and I will also speak like the British. In the About You category, you also want to include your appearance. Some things you can change in your appearance is your height, your hair color, your hair length. You can also give your DR self tattoos or piercings if you wish. You can also script that your DR self will not have any acne. Those are only a few suggestions. The possibilities are unlimited. For me, I don't really want to change my appearance in any way. I really love the way I look right now in my current reality. It's really all about that self-love. Yeah, so I'm gonna say in my desired reality, my appearance will be the same as my current reality. The next thing I like to include are personality and character traits. A few examples are friendliness, funny or humorous, smart or intelligent. There's also being an introvert or extrovert. Some of the traits you can have is being curious or being fun. If you want, you can also say that you're a jokester or troublemaker, like the Weasley twins. I mean, I feel like everybody wants to be around them. I know I would. I'm gonna say my personality / character traits are friendliness, humorous because I want to be funny. I also want to be smart. I also think it'd be really nice to be fun and extroverted. In the About You section, you also can't forget about the personal characteristics from your DR world. For me, because I'm shifting to the Harry Potter world, I can't forget about my Hogwarts house. So I took the official quiz and my Hogwarts house is actually Gryffindor. You also want to script your Patronus and your wand. When I took the quiz, my Patronus came out to be a falcon. And my wand is made out of alderwood with a unicorn hair core. It is 11 inch and slightly springy flexibility. In your script, you also want to include if you have a pet and your breed or blood status. I'm gonna say I will have a pet owl just because owls are so useful. I also want to be a pureblood, so that is what I'm gonna say. I am a pureblood. In this section, you also want to include your talents. Quidditch seems like a fun sport to play, so I'm gonna say I will play Quidditch. I'm also gonna say that I will be a well-rounded player, good at all roles, but I will excel at being a seeker and chaser. I'm also gonna say that I will excel in magic, just because I hear it's pretty hard to do, but I'm gonna cap off my talents there. I think having two talents is enough. I don't want to be talented at everything because let's be real, no one really loves someone who's good at everything. Some other talent suggestions could be wizard's chess. You could say you were good at playing wizard's chess. You can also say that you were good at inventing joke shop products like the Weasley twins, or if you really want to be a baddie, never saying that again. But if you want to be evil, you could say that you are good at dark magic. This just came to my mind right now, but you can also say that you are good at riding a dragon or dealing with magical creatures in general. Again, for this, the possibilities are unlimited. The last idea I have for you to include in the About You section of your shifting script is your family and its history. I'm gonna say my family consists of me, my older sister, and my mom and dad. I want to live in Godric's Hollow, so I'm gonna put that in as well. I'm gonna say that my family is quite wealthy and we have a house elf. I'm gonna script that Dobby is our house elf because I love Dobby. One more thing I'm going to include about my family is that everybody in my family belong to the Gryffindor house. Moving on to the next section, which is your DR world life. The first thing I'm going to include is the date I will arrive at when I successfully shift. I want to arrive on the first day of my sixth year at Hogwarts. I'm going to write in my shifting script that when I successfully shift, I will arrive at September 1st, 1996. Something else you can also script is your friends, your best friends, and your love interests. I'm gonna script that I will be friends with Ron, Hermione, and Harry. I will be the fourth addition to the group. As for my love interest, I don't know who that would be. So I'm just gonna say that I will find my love interest naturally. Here's like the tough part though. I feel like when you script your relationships and your friendships, because you're saying I'm friends with this person or I'm in love with this person, it's kind of like you're forcing the relationship. So if you are scripting your relationships, I think it is also important to include in your script that your relationships will be natural and not forced. Something you can include in this section are the courses you will take at Hogwarts. I can't remember how many courses you're supposed to take in your sixth year at Hogwarts, but we're just going to disregard the minimum amount. So I'm just going to script the courses that I'm interested in. I will say at Hogwarts, I will be taking Transfiguration, Potions, Charms, Defense Against the Dark Arts, and Herbology. 5 courses is a good amount. I'm gonna also say that I know Hogwarts very well and I can navigate the halls with ease. I'm also gonna say that I am able to find the room of requirement whenever I need it. Ooh, I also want to be friends with all the ghosts and the paintings there because, you know, the more the merrier. I'm also gonna put that in my script. I also want a chance to visit Hogsmeade, so I will write down, I will have permission to visit Hogsmeade. This next thing I'm gonna put in my DR world life is so important because I want my DR world to be happy and a safe place, and it definitely can't be a happy place if Voldemort exists. So I'm gonna script that Voldemort and Tom Riddle does not exist in my desired reality. If you want a chance to fight Voldemort, or if you want to be buddies with Voldemort, you can say that Voldemort is there. Maybe you can script that Voldemort isn't evil. That would be very interesting. I almost forgot to script this, but I'm also gonna say that I will own the invisibility cloak. One of the Deathly Hallows. I'm gonna make that clear that it's one of the Deathly Hallows just so I don't receive a fake one from like a joke shop maybe. That is all I'm gonna include in my DR world life. What I scripted are just a few suggestions, but you can totally add more or add less if you want to. Essentially, all you're doing is writing down everything you want your DR world to be like. It can include things you want to have, things you want to do, what your environment looks like, or who you want to see there. The last section of your script is what I call the rules. The first rule I'm gonna add to my script is that 1 week in my desired reality is equal to 1 hour in my current reality. It is also important to include in your script that no time in your desired reality will pass when you're in your current reality. I am also going to include that my DR will pause when I leave it. When you return back to your DR, you will start where you left off. It is also important to include in your script an indicator to tell you that you have successfully shifted. The indicator I want to notify me when I successfully shift is a scent. So I'm gonna say, when I have successfully shifted, I will smell strawberries. This next thing is so important to include in your shifting script, and that is a safe word or safe phrase. So once you successfully shift, you need a way to come back to your CR, and that is through a safe word or safe phrase. So a safe word or safe phrase is a word or phrase you say to return back to your current reality. I'm gonna use a safe phrase, and my safe phrase will be back to my current reality. Plain and simple. If you want, you can also do a safe action. Essentially, it's the same thing. A safe action is just an action you do to return back to your current reality. I am personally not gonna write a safe action, nor do I prefer it, just because I might naturally do this action with no intention to return back to my current reality. My example, I use jumping. So let's say there's a rock in my path and I just need to jump over it. But jumping over that rock that's in my way might accidentally return me back to my CR. And obviously I don't want that, so that is why I don't include a safe action. I just stick to my safe phrase. Another rule that I think is important to script is that you will remember everything that happened in your DR when you return back to your CR. That is crucial if you don't want to forget what happened in your DR. Another thing I'm gonna include is that I will feel minimal pain. I cannot get sick or die. Because I really don't want to die in my DR. I highly recommend you script that you will not die in your DR. That way you can return back to your CR. But I mean, if you really want to live in your DR forever and just die there, go for it. I'm not really here to stop you. The last thing I'm going to include in my shifting script is my waiting room. And I'm going to say, my waiting room will look like King's Cross Station. And that is my completed new and updated shifting script. Before I print out the script, I'm gonna go over it for spelling and grammar issues because I know there's a lot of it. It really is a challenge to type, talk, and film at the same time, not gonna lie. As you can see, my script is only about a page and a half long. I purposely do that because I don't want to have a long script. What I like to do is read my script before I attempt to shift. And I really don't want to read an essay before I go to bed because reading a very long script will probably put me to sleep before I actually attempt to shift. Yeah, so that is why I like to keep my script short and sweet. If you're watching this right now and you think I forgot some important details to include in my shifting script, let me know in the comments down below so I can add it to my script. Alright guys, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And be sure to check out my other shifting videos. I will link them down below in the description box. With that, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye! Pull the key out the ignition. Run your mouth but I never listen. You hold me back, will never last. Keep talking all your shit. Wondering how all this started. You left me brokenhearted. You flip my words, yeah this love hurts. Keep talking all your shit.